Russia, the separatists, and Ukraine all have the capacity to put an end to the fight. Meanwhile, the United States is going to continue to lead efforts within the world community to de-escalate the situation, to stand up for the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Ukraine, and to support the people of Ukraine as they courageously work to strengthen their democracy and make their own decisions about how they should move forward. Before I take just a couple of questions, let me remark on one other issue. This morning I spoke with Prime Minister Netanyahu of Israel about the situation in Gaza. We discussed Israel's military operation in Gaza, including its efforts to stop the threat of terrorist infiltration through tunnels into Israel. I reaffirmed my strong support for Israel's right to defend itself. No nation should accept rockets being fired into its borders or terrorists tunneling into its territory. In fact, while I was having the conversation with Prime Minister Netanyahu, sirens went off in Tel Aviv. I also made clear that the United States and our friends and allies are deeply concerned about the risks of further escalation and the loss of more innocent life. And that's why we've indicated, although we support military efforts by the Israelis to make sure that rockets are not being fired into their territory, we also have said that our understanding is the current military ground operations are designed to deal with the tunnels, and we are hopeful that Israel will continue to approach this process in a way that minimizes civilian casualties, and that all of us are working hard to return to the ceasefire that was reached in November of 2012. Secretary Kerry is working to support Egypt's initiative to pursue that outcome. I told Prime Minister Netanyahu that John is prepared to travel to the region following additional consultations. Let me close by making one additional comment. On board Malaysian Airlines flight MH17, there were apparently nearly 100 researchers and advocates traveling to an international conference in Australia dedicated to combating AIDS, HIV. These were men and women who had dedicated their own lives to saving lives of others, and they were taken from us in a senseless act of violence. In this world today, we shouldn't forget that in the midst of conflict and killing, there are people like these. People who are focused on what can be built rather than what can be destroyed. People who are focused on how they can help people that they've never met. People who define themselves not by what makes them different from other people, but by the humanity that we hold in common.
A huge wave of zombies approaching.
It's important for us to lift them up.
Final wave is over. Cabbage plant shoots cabbages at a zombie. See you next time.